our gospel reading today. That's why in Cebuano, pagkaalaot ninyo. I usually hear that line from Jesus every time I pray. Basig ako pod, kay na ako sa position, I'm a priest, tapos, no, if I'm not aware of my actions, my words, basig ingana pod ang ingon sa mga tao sa kuha. I hope in your case also, as devotees of St. Joseph, you also have the chance to reflect on that. Usahay manggod when we nurture a particular devotion to a particular saint, no, usahay magka naanatay uniform, ano, naanatay group, naanatay mga prayer meetings and masses like this. When we develop that, other people would see us as apart from them, and then the group becomes exclusive, and because it is exclusive, no, wala na sila'y part, wala na sila'y lugar sa atong grupo. That is the extreme situation, I'm sure. Pero ingana ang nahitabo dinhi sa mga tao sa gospel reading nato, the Pharisees and the teachers of the law, no, consider themselves as a separate group. Actually, ano, sila ang mga quote-unquote, no, pinili sa Ginoo, no, they are the chosen ones apart from the people, so nai distance. The problem is sa atong gospel reading, Jesus is pointing out how the Pharisees and the teachers of the law behave, no, and the way how they teach the law and how they practice the tradition. Usahay manggod, no, the most angry, judgmental, ano unsa pa, na mga tao na sa sulod sa simbahan. In defense nga ay kami ang nakahibalo sa ano, sa scripture, kami ang nakahibalo sa mga policy sa simbahan, kami ang nakahibalo ingani ingana, and so we will defend that to the point that we become angry at people. Makaguol, no? For I think, and I hope, kining gospel reading nadunggan nato karon is a point of reflection for all of us, you know, that an effective leader, an effective mass goer, an effective Christian is someone who live out, even to the grassroots, that those people who are unchurched will see in us as bearers of Christ. I think that is a challenge not only to me, but also to all of us here, nga ang atong pagkinabuhi unta maging ano, that Christ becomes obvious in the way we live, in the way we say things, in the way we treat others. Through that, no, kung maging konkreto sa ato ang kinabuhi, ang mga ginatudlo, no, sa ang mga policies nato, ang mga nabasa nato sa scripture, no, ang mga laws nga atong nabalaan dinhi sa ano, sa simbahan, naunta, as we live that in our lives and God becomes obvious in our lives, other people would say, ah, okay, di ay kini okay siya nga deboto ni San Jose, no, ako pod magdevelop pod ko og ingana nga devotion kay San Jose, kay nakita na ako sa iyaha ang si Kristo mismo. Amen. No, I think that is a good challenge to all of us as we continue this Holy Mass and develop our devotion to Saint Joseph. And I'm sure Saint Joseph will be very happy if we become little by little, become more Christ-like in our words, in our actions, and in our relationship with each other. Amen. Amen. Let us all stand.